I was recently commissioned to make a large Nixie tube display out of 121 Nixie tubes. It will be a matrix 11x11 mounted on a 4x4 meters large wall. And our Nixie tube is too small for this project, so I will need to come up with something bigger. And I decided to make a Nixie tube 150 millimeters in diameter. So it will be really large tube. And if I succeed, this will be the biggest front view Nixie tube ever made. So I thought it would be interesting to document the process of development and all the like decision choices and other stuff along the way. Because normally I just write or talk about things, what happened, skipping the problematic parts and just talking about what led to the successful design. So this will be first video from this like small series, and today I will talk just about like the plans and what we have already. It's not much, but so as for the construction, it will be inspired by a CRT tubes. This is not a CRT tube, but just for illustration, with the front window, and here will be the glass envelope, which is getting narrow at this point, and with the base with pins. So it will be like this. The plan is to first assemble the internal system. It will be pretty much the same as in all the front view Nixie tubes. So the some kind of anode cup. There will be the digits and symbols inside. We have here the ceramic rods and the insulators holding the digit stack at place. And on top of this will be anode screen. It's not here visible now. There will be another part of the internal system which will hold the stem. Like the only purpose of this is to hold the stem during the sealing and then inside the tube. So here will be the stem. It's our standard stem with just a little bit longer wires. So this should be pretty much easy. We don't need to develop anything on this. So here is the internal system. Here you can see ceramic rods here. And the wires will be held on the ceramic rods by ceramic adhesive. So I will coat here a line of ceramic adhesive, and after curing it will firmly hold the wires on two places against the ceramic rods. So this will be quite strong bond, and it will help us to manipulate with the tube while the stem is already attached. After finishing the internal assembly, we will insert it into the glass envelope. It will be inserted from this side, from the bigger side. Here on these two metal rings, we will need metal springs, which will hold the internal system against the glass. So maybe I see already here, I will need to move this a little bit down. After inserting the system inside, I will seal the window here. So I will put the window on the envelope and seal it with the torch along this edge. Because this edge will be hot, I don't want to oxidize or damage the internal system by the heat. So for this reason, it's at this time it's sitting deep inside, and after the seal is made and the glass is cooled down, I will move back the internal system a little bit towards the glass window so that it's better visible from the front. During the sealing, I'm planning to purge the tube from this side by nitrogen, which should protect the internal system from oxygen and from the heat. We will see how it will work. And once this edge is sealed and the internal system is moved inside, I will seal this place against the stem, like this envelope to the stem. This is the standard process what we already do and what we know pretty well from our Nixie tube. So I don't expect any surprises here. There are a lot of things which are unclear now, as you can see, like there is half things missing which are not designed, like the symbols, the connection from the digits here to the stem will be quite a challenge, because they will have to be electrically insulated against the anode so that these wires doesn't glow. This will be interesting. So this is all for the construction. In the next videos, I will focus on all the individual parts and all the manufacturing steps which are necessary for the tube to be made. We have roughly 4 months. The all the project must be finished in September 2020 so that we can mount it at the place in October 2020. And I will call this tube Tube H, H like the first letter of the city where it will be mounted. So thanks for watching, and in the following days I want to start with the glass, because as you can see I already made some tests on the ceiling, and then I will talk about other stuff. So that's all for today.